Hi BCBs, welcome to my channel Reale Eyes. I don't think you would need premium processing for this if you're like fairly starting 4.5 months before. So it will be approved at least in like 4 months or 4.5 months. I suggest don't go for premium processing. Go for normal processing. Once you have the receipt, you can show that receipt to your employer and you can work for 6 months. And they have increased it to 540 days now. So when I have applied, I received it for 180 days, but you might receive it for 540 days, which is equivalent to 1.5 years. So that is good enough. And you have the receipt with you. Even though it takes longer, it's totally fine. So here we are. I hope you have received your STEM OPT I-20. Let's just log into USICF's portal and see how to actually apply for STEM OPT and what are the fields that you have to select and how much you have to pay,
etc. This is kind of quite similar to what you have applied for your OPT. You have to sign into your USICS account. After signing in, go to My Account and click on File a Form Online. Then select the one which you wanted to apply. In this case, we have to select I-765, Application for Employee Authorization. And underneath, for your eligible category, you have to select STEM Extension. So after that, click on Start Form and you will be navigated to the next page. Here you can find all the details that are required for you to start your application. Please go through them and drop your comments if you have any questions. So after going through all of them, click on next and you can start your form online. When you start your application, you have to fill certain details. Your eligibility criteria is STEM extension. Your degree should be the one which you have perceived. And your employee name. Then the number, the E-Verify number. You can find E-Verify number in your I-983. And they will ask you if you would like to go for premium processing. Since you have already applied OPT, so this will be a renewal of permission to accept employment. And if they ask you, like, have you filed a form? So you can select whatever you like, but I selected no. Then the details, this page is completely about your details. Please fill as many as personal details that you can. Number, email, ID, address, etc. And the city, town or village of your birth should be according to your passport. So you have to fill that information in here. Even though it's optional, you can fill the state and country of birth along with date of birth. So your country will be India or whatever the country that you're born. And you can find I-94 information in your form or you can check this online. Anyway, you would need that form and documents. So enter that particular record here. And you can find this information. When did you last arrive in the United States in your I-94? So basically have that information handy and you have to provide that information. So you would need to provide this details if you have traveled in between while you're perceiving your master's. So you have to enter the place of arrival and the status. So if you're F1 while you are traveling, you should enter like F1. So after entering the status, then you have to fill your recently issued passport number. You can find all this information in your passport and make sure that you're entering the right details. So after completing all your basic information, you can find your service information in your I-20, and I just kept it blank, my A number, but you can, if you know, you can just fill it. Otherwise, the system will automatically fill that information. And this is specifically if you don't have a social security card. If you have it, then if you don't have it, you can select no. If you have it, just enter your social security number and you'll be fine. And the next section is basically your documents that are required. As you can see, the first document is a 2x2 photo. So if you have filled your OPT, you can use the same 2x2, but make sure that your I-94 is updated from your OPT. Choose that document and upload it. Then you should enter your EAD card. That will be your OPT EAD card. Upload your OPT EAD and you'll be fine. Then you would need Form I-20 and your college degree. So that is your graduate degree. For institution accreditation, I have uploaded my STEM OPT I-20 again. I do not have any additional information, so I left it blank and I clicked on next. So the next page would be for you to pay $470. So make sure that you have reviewed everything and you have paid the amount so that your application is in process.
Thank you so much. I hope you find this helpful. Please subscribe and like, share, and comment this particular video so that it will help me, it will motivate me to make more videos. Thank you so much.